would be a sound recording. I gotta go for it.
All right, everyone. Welcome to Infusion Season 1, right?
It's season one. It's a one time.
So, yeah. Oh, the one time. Oh, okay.
I mean, Season 1 is still correct.
Yeah. It might. I mean, if this is successful, though, it might continue. Also, I find a village.
Who knows? Oh, nice.
Nothing really, but I mean, hey, might as well take it.
You tried.
Yeah, got some food.
Yeah.
And I think there's probably a library here.
That split spawn, uh-oh. Look out.
Oh yeah, yeah, I forgot about that. So what are the game modes? Compensation?
It's like half spawn. Compensation, split spawn, move 0-0.
Ah, I gotcha.
Fast smelting. Woohoo.
Wow.
And I think that's it. I don't know.
Alright. That's fair.
And I got like half an hour of sleep. I tried.
You made her definitely overslept. I didn't actually know this round was today. Like, I had English to do. Right. And I was like, oh, wait, this round's in an hour. Uh-oh. So yeah. I guess I'm gonna do English later. I'll be working a little bit late.
I set my alarm like a good boy. Not that it really mattered, but...
like, round times and all that. Right. Good thing I wake up fairly early, so yeah. I don't really miss them.
Yeah.
So how many anime have you actually watched? Like,
Sure, a lot.
Have you watched Madoka Magica?
No.
That's pretty good anime. Finished that a little bit ago. It adds a little bit of a twist to it. It's kind of like it's a regular, like... kinda girly, I guess, like magical girl anime, but it has adds like a serious twist that makes it really dark and incredibly artistic anime. It's really good, actually.
Yeah, maybe I'll check it out then.
You should. It's really underrated, I think. But everyone who's actually like seen it liked it. I think you'll like it.
That's pretty cool.
But don't judge the beginning too harshly, because it does come off as like a lolicon anime at the beginning, because it tries to, but because like it tries to trick you, kind of.
Ah.
Yeah.
It tries to trick me, huh?
Yeah, it does. Jeez.
Watch out for that.
Yeah, it's like one of those kind of. It's not really a psychological horror, really, but it falls into that same sort of thing. Like, have you ever heard of like DDLC? I think it's called.
Doki Doki.
Yeah, it's like kind of falls under that where like it tries to act all girly cute, but it's not really
cutesy, but
yeah,
on the inside it's no.
It's not quite as like psycho as DDLC, but I mean, I think it's a lot better than DDLC, but it's still like, you know,
yeah,
it's still like kind of the same sort of like deceiving kind of thing.
Okay, which that's I do interesting. Like anime.
What's it called? So I've really only watched like Hunter x Hunter, which is insanely good.
Yeah.
I've watched My Hero Academia, which was not one of my first, but like my first shonen, I believe.
Oh, yeah.
And that's a good anime. I liked season 1. Season 2 is good.
Yeah.
Season 3 has been pretty good. The fight between All Might and One for All really good.
Yeah, that episode was like, oh man.
Yeah, that was an amazing episode. Like,
intense as shit.
The troll's like exam arc was kind of boring. I think that's when like a lot of criticism began to come for the series. But I'm glad that, you know, spoiler alert, anyone who's watching this, I'm glad that Todoroki actually like didn't pass in Season of Bakugo, because it shows that there are some stakes to the show, which is good.
True.
Keeps you interested. There's no real point watching a show if there's no stakes.
Yeah, definitely. I accidentally like spoiled myself and like stuff like that. I watched a video where it was like going through the manga. So I was like, I'm interested. I'm like, what's this? A wolf?
Yeah.
I knew that like Todoroki and Bakugo didn't pass and shit.
Have you heard of the, I don't know if me saying this would be a spoiler. Okay, how far are you in the manga?
No, I haven't read it at all. I've just seen like some like future parts of it.
Okay, well, you do know that Dobby is a pretty prominent figure in the manga, right?
Dobby's the blue flame guy, right?
Yeah. Do you know that figure?
Nope, I did not.
Okay, then I won't say anything
else. I've heard that there's a lot of theories about him, but I don't know.
Yeah, there are a lot of theories.
Yeah.
So now let's talk about the most interesting parts of an anime when you figure out someone else likes it. What's your favorite character in My Hero Academia?
God, My Hero. Honestly, I really like Todoroki.
Yeah, fair. He had a lot of character development in season 2.
Yeah, definitely. Big fan of that.
Let me think. My favorite's probably Suyu.
Oh, yeah.
I like Suyu a lot. Yeah. Frog girl. He's cool.
God, I can't remember her name.
Shigaraki.
Shigaraki, yeah.
It's a little underrated. I know a lot of people don't like Shigaraki. I'm a fan of him, though. I think he's kind of cool.
Yeah, I also like a girl. I don't remember her name. The Gravity Girl.
Toga?
No, Gravity Girl. Uchako or something? Uraka, yeah. Uraka. I like her. She's cool.
I like her. Like, I love her design and I like her character, but I wish her whole character wasn't I'm in love with Deku. It's kind of annoying.
I mean, it wasn't that like that at the start. It's like started happening this season.
It's just I like her a lot, but I want to see her do something like that's kind of like have a badass moment or something like that.
Yeah, like when she was facing Bakugo in the tournament.
In season 2,
that dad was like, "Oh my god."
Yeah, that was cool.
Yeah.
I just want to see another one of those, because whenever she gets screen time, a lot of the time, she's just looking at Deku. And yeah, I like Midori, I mean, I don't dislike him by any means, but it's just, it's annoying that, like, that's her only real character development.
Well, what can you do? Girls, am I right?
Yeah, girls. Who's your favorite character in Hunter x Hunter?
Killua, dude.
Yeah,
that's my boy.
My favorite, actually, well, technically my favorite is Bisky, and then Killua.
Bisky's good, yeah.
I think it's, my list is like Bisky, Killua, Meruem.
Dude,
he's such a good character, honestly.
He is.
Especially, like, if you rewatch the Chimera Ant arc and, like, look at a bunch of analysis videos, you get to realize, like, how much development he has.
Yeah.
He goes from some, like, really boring, just not cool, like, basic villain who just kills things because he wants to establish power from them, and then he actually becomes, like, really interesting with his development through Kamugi.
Yeah. I'll be honest, when I was watching the Chimera arc, like, near the end of it, I was, like, starting to get a little bored because it was, like,
It
starts slowing down big time towards the end.
It's a long arc. It's like when you actually compare it to the original Hunter x Hunter, like 1990, it's around the same episodes as the original Hunter x Hunter, because the original Hunter x Hunter did not cover up anything until Greed Island. Like, it only covered up to Greed Island.
Isn't there a new, like, Hunter thing coming out? Like a Greed Island 2 or something.
Manga volume.
But it's like special or something, I think.
If you might be talking about the movies, but the movies are really bad and they're also not canon.
I don't know, there's something new that's coming out, but it's like a second Greed Island or something.
Maybe. But I do know that a new manga volume is coming out, because you know Hunter x Hunter is also called Hiatus x Hiatus, because the manga just like, let me see, the actual anime, the 2011 version, ended in like 2015, right?
Yeah.
In 2018, there's only been like 40 chapters in the manga.
Oh, wow.
For like for a whole 3 years. Yeah. It's pretty crazy.
How far is the manga gone?
Again, only 40 chapters above the regular anime from when it ended.
Right.
It covers something that was briefly mentioned by Jing. You know Jing, right? He's John's father.
Yeah.
What's called? It was briefly mentioned by him. It was called a Dark Continent. And that is really covered in the in the manga. It's actually incredibly interesting, and they make Kurapika like a badass. Like Kurapika is like the main character practically in the manga.
Dude, I wish Kurapika like came back more, but like
I love Kurapika.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Oh, I said, hey, we're together. Yeah. Look.
So much for Slipspawn. What's called? But yeah, I'm a big fan of Kurapika. Just such a level-headed person. Very nice.
What the fuck?
Oh, wow.
Why are you flying?
It's like Captain Falcon, yeah, it is. I want to go over here. Do you have any books, actually?
Nope.
Oh, he must have gotten the book.
Yeah, he definitely.
Let's just go over here then, because it's actually going to be a pretty big advantage that we're together.
Yeah, that's actually real true. It's full line already.
Yeah.
It's fast melting, but like, oh my god.
I have 14 right now. Actually, I have 18 technically.
I've got 69. Got the iron from the
blacksmith. Alright, we're getting there.
We're on our way up.
What's it called? But yeah, they make Kurapika like a really prominent part of the manga. And as you probably figured, Gon is not a prominent character at all in the manga.
Oh,
what
really?
I really like about Hunter x Hunter is that it's the kind of, it's like, these are the main characters, but we're just going to exclude some main characters. And I find that interesting. Like in the Chimariant arc, you actually never saw Kurapika.
Yeah.
Or Lardia. And then.
Yeah, that's true. You only saw him until like one scene after the Chimera.
Yeah, just like tiny, tiny bit.
Just not answering the phone as just sitting there. Like.
And,
I found Lin Boy.
Hey, Lin Boy. And, what was I saying? Oh, yeah, yeah. And with the election arc, you only saw Lordia, and you still didn't see Kurapika, so Kurapika is very prominent in the,
Alright. I stole an apple from
cool
him.
Character.
Easy clip.
Do you want me to spoil you something about Gon? It's not like a spoil, it's just kind of funny. He goes back to Whale Island, because he did that with Nen, and then he does homework with Miyuto.
He just does homework.
Yeah, he just does homework, so like nice. The whole time Kurapika and like Jing and all of them are like going to the Dark Continent. It's like, hey, there's Gon doing some homework.
Nice.
Dude, P2's death was so brutal.
Dude, which one's that?
That's the one, how can you forget? That's the one that where Gon transforms.
Okay, yeah, I just didn't remember the name, oh my god.
So
I knew it was
brutal,
one of them,
dude.
But yeah, holy fuck. Dude, I fucking spoiled myself that like a couple years before I watched the anime, which was like this year or last year or something.
I only spoiled myself with really one thing, and that was the I knew that Killua had lightning because I was looking at Hunter x Hunter wallpapers, since I like collect wallpapers, so it's like my hobby. And what was I saying? Oh yeah, and I saw like an electricity wallpaper, which is kind of a spoiler.
Yeah, I was just like watching like anime scenes, and I saw, you know, him fighting Pito. I was like, oh, is that just like an ability he can do? He just turn big. Okay. And then when I was watching the anime, I'm like, oh, that's probably the end.
Yeah, that's a big
ooh.
That's actually probably one of like the biggest spoilers you can get.
Yep, well, what can you do?
Actually, probably the biggest spoiler is that the whole Royal Guard this is a bigger
oh, is that an actual
spoiler for anyone who's listening.
Yeah.
The fact that the whole Royal Guard plus Meruem died to a bomb set by Netero. Who was your favorite out of the Royal Guard?
The Royal Guard.
That was P2, Yuppie,
yeah.
And Poop.
Probably just Pito, honestly.
Yeah, Pito's probably the best. I think my favorite personally is Yuppie, because I really like his development.
Yeah, cool.
He goes from like kind of a meathead, if that makes sense, like one of those guys who are like, I'm really strong, but I don't really think much, to someone who like values honor and all that.
There's actually a lot of
symbolism in Hunter x Hunter. It's really interesting to read about. Like, there's a scene where Meruem says something like, do you know my name? Or like, does it matter if I know my name? P2 says it's important, like whatever makes you feel better, which shows that P2 kind of focuses on like feelings.
Right.
Poof said, it's, you know, your name is king because you are like a king, the definition of a king, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
And that really makes sense because Poof like the whole time is trying to convince Meruem to like become a generic villain and just like take over humanity, whereas he has this human part of him. And Yuppie says like he can't answer that question because his focus isn't really that at all. He's like all about honor and, you know, glory through that kind of thing. So it's just very interesting because you can tell that Pito is more like about feelings and all that, and you know, Poof is just about his own little objectives. Like he doesn't care. A good way to put it is like Poof doesn't care about Meruem. He cares about the king.
Yeah, yeah. But Poof was like being annoying.
What happened?
What happened? Jake died.
Oh, what?
Oh, Jake.
Aw. That sucks. Damn.
Yep.
I found a spawner, by the way.
Yeah, I found some gold.
That's my doggy. I hope you don't mind.
It's fine. It's keeping me awake.
That's good, that's good. Yeah, it's a zombie spawner.
That is.
It's like, I feel like if Jake lagged, then he'd probably be respawned. If he lagged.
Maybe, I don't know. It is still first episode.
Yeah.
It's up to them.
I'm gonna show my dark flashlight so my dogs don't keep on coming in and out.
Okay.
I'll be right back. Alright. Have you ever watched Naruto?
Nope. I've seen a lot of like fight scenes and like stuff like that.
I think while I was watching the Vader, you showed me like funny clips or something about it. And I think I got spoiled really hard about a character. And you know Still Who, right? Do you know?
Yeah.
He really wanted me to watch Naruto, and I think I just spoiled myself pretty damn hard
about
a character named Toby.
Yeah, I know about that, yeah. I know about pretty much everything.
Damn, dude.
Like, all the main battles and shit, like, oof.
Yeah. I can still watch it, it's not like a huge spoiler, but it's still pretty big.
Definitely.
What's your favorite anime, anyways?
My favorite anime? I don't know, I'd have to, like, think about it.
It's a difficult question.
It really is.
You were saying something else about the Naruto, my bad. Oh, I thought you were saying something else about Naruto, but I interrupted you by accident.
It wasn't. Fuck. Man, this is not fast mount.
Yeah, it's not. I thought it was.
I thought it was.
I was thinking maybe like I used something in my furnace wrong or something like that, but no, it's just not fast mount. Shout out to my dog for opening my door when I shut it.
Shout out.
By the way, there's nothing really in the dungeon.
No, damn.
Just like iron and music discs.
This cave seems pretty fucking big though.
Probably.
Yeah,
it's just good where they're in a cave together.
Just having to find each other.
Yeah. Okay. So what have you been up to?
Not too much.
Like school stuff, or?
Nah, I don't do that shit, man.
Oh.
I'm out of school.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm just play games, watch anime. It's like, that's all fair. I
that's
do.
That's a life to live.
For now.
Yeah.
It's chilling.
I've been, what's it called? Have you played Zelda games?
Yeah, yep.
What's it called? I'm actually doing like a Wind Waker randomizer thing.
Oh, I've heard about those, yeah.
Yeah, I'm doing a Still right now. We're doing like a race. It's so fun.
That's
I think
cool.
we're gonna stream it next time we do and try and get like maybe more people.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
It's a lot of fun, actually. Because like, you it's like completely different game practically.
Yeah, I've seen
so much changes.
Some like stream highlights from other people doing it.
Yeah. Probably will do something like that.
Yeah.
Could just be fun to do. Let me think.
I'm one iron short from a helmet.
Nice. I just got full iron.
Boiled again.
I have a bow with stacking 30 arrows, so if I find someone, then...
Already?
Go down.
Oh, man.
Yeah. I found a lot of chickens, and I got lucky with my string. And
I found a lot. I got 42 feathers.
Damn. Already?
Yeah. Got a ton of chickens. Where I spawned.
I think you went down this cave, so I'm gonna go
I
up and get some water.
There. There's a couple water pools around down here.
Might as well just go up here.
Yeah, okay. This pack is full bright.
Hell
so,
yeah.
Whoops. It's like the one pack I like right now. It's like, oh hell.
What pack is it?
Someone's pack that they released in 2015. I just sort of have it, I don't know why.
Nice.
It's a pack I have, I was like,
When I first got my new computer and played Minecraft, I just like went on Twitter and tried to find packs, and I found Squish's pack, and it's pretty good. I don't think I played Minecraft anymore, but it's a good pack.
Nice.
See you guys next episode.
Yeah, well.